Welcome to our new tutorial on Python. We are going to teach you about Python from the scratch. We are going to understand how to install the software, how to create a list, and how to import Excel or CSV files into Python. So let's dive in. First of all, you need to install the software. So go to Google and write download Anaconda. In the first link, whatever you get, you go there and you go to download. You are going to have all the links to download the software. If it's your computer is 64-bit, you click over here, or else 32-bit. It's better to install Python 3.7, not Python 2.7. For Mac or Linux, you can go and download from these links. You click on this link, automatically it will start downloading. But I have already downloaded it. This one I will cancel it. This is the software exe file. Then you click, double click on it. It will ask you to run. Click on run and then keep clicking on the next button, and I agree, it will be installed. I have already done that. So in all programs you are going to get a Anaconda. In Anaconda you have Anaconda Navigator, Anaconda Prompt. I will talk about it later on, but you will be clicking on the spider. This is how spider will look like. This is how the software will look like. Over here in the left hand side, this is where you write all your codes, and in the console you get to see all your output. You can increase this window size. You also have variable explorer, file explorer, which we will require it later on, not now. We will concentrate only on this Python console. There are different libraries what you can install, which comes pre-built with Anaconda Spider. Like I want to install a library called OS, so I just need to write import OS and press F9 to execute this code. If I press F9, the entire line will get executed. Then import pandas. I will import the pandas library, but I don't want to write pandas every time, so I will put an alias like as pd. So henceforth if I write pd, I will refer to pandas. Similarly, I will write import numpy and I will name it as np. These are the standard notation. Now if I want to create a group of numbers in Python, then which is called a list, I can write a equals to 1. So a will be created with single value as 1. I press F9, so a has one value as 1. I can write multiple values like 1, 2, 3, but whenever you are writing multiple values, you need to put it in quotes. I'm sorry, not quotes, it's third bracket, and press F9. It will give 1, 2, 3, so it overrides the previous one, which was 1. Similarly, I can create some characters as well, like b equals 2. Now whenever you are writing character, I need to put it in quotes, inverted quotes, like a, b and c, and then b will be having a, b, c. I can stitch all these different things, these list, like a, b, and I can create more to create a data frame. Data frame is like a matrix like structure which holds different list, which might be numeric, which might be characters. And how do I do that? First I will create a data frame. Let's name it as data equals to data frame. I'm sorry, you need to write pd.dataframe. Okay, and don't write anything else. So data will be a data frame having nothing in it. Okay, you can also add comment over here, and you also add a comment by putting a hash sign. So this is how you create a data frame. So presently data is a blank, there is nothing, but I can add something by writing data within third bracket and putting inverted quotes. I can write name. That means within data frame data, I am adding a new column which whose name is name. So in name, I can add maybe A, B and C. So now data frame will be having a single column whose name is name and which has values A, B, C. Similarly, I can add more values into it by saying maybe instead of name I can write age. Age are numbers, so I can directly write the numbers without having the quotes, maybe 12, 19 and 7. So this will be added an extra within the data frame data. Now I have two. Similarly, I can add more data, maybe sex. Okay, and sex again, this has to be within quotes because these are the characters, maybe female, female and male. So this becomes a data frame. You can keep on adding more rows and more columns into it, but in reality we don't create the data frames manually like this. We import the data. The two most common format what we usually import is either Excel or CSV. Suppose we have over here two different files, both names are data. Okay, this one is a CSV file, this one is an Excel file. I want to import it. So how do I do that? First, you copy the path where you have kept all your files. You go here and you write, I'm going to use this OS library. You write os.ch means change, dir means directory, and within bracket, within quotes, I will put the path. Now remember, this path single slash, make it all double slash, or make it change into front slash, either double backslash or single front slash, but don't do a mix and match, otherwise it's not going to work. And press control, I mean not control, it's only F9. In case you have missed out, it's going to give you an error. Okay, you will understand. That means you have made a mistake. So this one is okay. Now I want to import first the CSV one whose name is data. So I will write, I will first give some name, suppose D underscore CSV, I will name it, equals to read underscore CSV. Okay, and then you simply write the name of the file which is data, data.csv. You also need to, I'm sorry, it's saying read underscore CSV not defined, my mistake, I should have written pd dot read underscore CSV. And now this will be imported. See, I have name, age and sex here also. In this data set I had the same sort of data, name, age and sex. It has been imported properly. Okay, now what if I want to import the Excel file? So what you can do, simply in the same way, read underscore Excel, and I will name it as D underscore Excel for you to understand, and pd data dot XLSX. Just one more thing you need to add, the sheet name. If I go to this one, if I check this one, okay, see the sheet name is data, so I need to add it over here. So I will add sheet underscore name equals to data. Always remember, this is case sensitive, this is small d, that's why I'll have to write small d, and close it and execute that, and see, it has been properly executed. Yes, we get the data set. All right, thank you so much for attending this tutorial. In the next tutorial, we are going to understand how do we manipulate the data. There are different ways to manipulate the data, And if you want to put any comments, please put it in our comment section. Any feedback, anything you want me to add further, please do that. All right. Thank you so much.